we are going to be talking about, you know, pending home sales that go wrong. So if you are selling a property, the number one reason why a property will really fall apart, from my estimations, would be a buyer having cold feet. Okay, so buyers, especially a lot of first-time home buyers, they are scared. Okay, they're wondering if the information that they're getting is good information. They're wondering if they are buying at the wrong time in the market. Cold feet normally usually happens with buyers within the first 10 business days of the transaction, because in Rhode Island, especially Massachusetts as well, these buyers can literally walk away for any reason at all during that inspection contingency period in the contract. Okay, so as a seller, you can definitely help out with this by giving the buyers a whole home inspection report up front. It's called a pre-list home inspection. Give it to them up front. Disclose absolutely everything. Allow the buyers to still do their own home inspection if they wish. However, fix all of the red flags, all of the reasons that would give them reason to walk away during this transaction. Numero two. The home inspections, which again would go back to the cold feet, but home inspections, you know, a lot of times sellers are looking at their house, they're looking at, you know, the floors, the ceilings, but they're not looking beneath. They're not looking, between the walls. They're not looking, or do not see the pests or the ants or the carpenter ants or the bugs or whatever it may be in the sill of the house. They might not see them in the walls, whatever it might be. They might not see the plumbing leaks, the electrical issues. I guarantee you, if you have an older home, you're going to have at least a 40-page inspection report, and there's going to be stuff on there, even if you've very well maintained your home for several years, that you did not realize. Another thing, too, obviously, is financing, okay? So financing can fall through for a buyer for a variety of reasons here. Let's talk about, you know, the number one thing that's happening right now is appraisal. So homes are selling oftentimes, or I should say pending oftentimes, above the appraised value, okay? So let's just say if, you know, your home should appraise at, say, $300,000 and you put it on the market for $310,000, you're already setting yourself up for failure, okay? So you want to make sure that you are selling your home at where the home can appraise. Now, there's a little bit of room, a little bit of wiggle room, usually about 1% to 2%, where an appraiser in an escalating market will allow for your home sales price to sell higher than the appraised value. But if you are higher and higher than that, then you are, again, you're setting yourself up for your home to not appraise. Another thing would be if the buyers got a mortgage loan rejection. Now, that does happen from time to time. Let's say the buyer goes out and does something silly, like purchases a sports car or, you know, a truck or whatever it is, makes a big purchase, pulls out credit cards, does all this stuff that throws their credit for a loop. That'll definitely create red flags for the bank, and they will most likely reject the buyer. Or if the buyer has a glitch in employment during your time period, keep in mind that the buyer has until the mortgage contingency date to pull out of this agreement, which is oftentimes about 30, 35 days from the fully executed purchase and sales agreement. And if that buyer does not get approved for that mortgage, that does not necessarily mean that's your agent's fault. You know, we cannot control what the public does.